Hello, welcome to Civil Engineering and Architecture Thoughts. Today, we are going to discuss a design problem on laterally supported beam. So here is our question. A simply supported joist of 4 meter effective span is laterally supported throughout. It carries a UDL of 10 kN per meter inclusive of self weight. Design an appropriate section using Fe250 steel. So it is provided that it is a simply supported joist and its span is 4 meter and that is laterally supported throughout. And it is carrying a load of 10 kN per meter, which is inclusive of self weight. So we have asked to design an appropriate section by using Fe250 steel. So let's start our solution. First of all, we have to find the factored UDL. That is, in question it is provided that the beam is loaded with 10 kN per meter. So to make it factored, we have to multiply that 10 by a factor 1.5. That is 1.5 into 10, that is equal to 15 kN meter. Next is factored bending moment mu is equal to, as we all know, for a simply supported beam, mu is equal to WL square by 8, that is 15 into 4 square by 8, that is equal to 240 kilonewton meter. In order to convert kilonewton into newton mm, we have to multiply 240 by 10 raised to 6, that is 240 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. Next is factored shear force Vu is equal to WL by 2, 15 into 4 by 2, that is equal to 30 kilonewton, 30 into 10 raised to 3 newton. Next is required plastic section modulus. ZP is equal to MU by Fy into gamma M0. MU is the factored bending moment, which we have obtained as 240 into 10 raised to 6, and Fy is the yield stress, that is 250. Gamma M0 is the factor 1.1, that is, we are obtaining that from IS 800 table 5. For compression member, gamma M0 is equal to 1.1, that is equal to 1056056 into 10 raised to 3 mm cube, that is equal to 1056 centimeter cube. By taking 20% extra, 1.2 into 1056, that is equal to 1267.20 centimeter cube. Next is details of the section. Here in this problem, we are taking ISLB 200, Indian standard lightweight beam 200 at a weight of 19.8 kilogram per meter. And we are taking the I section. So the details, we can take this from either from SP6 or from steel table. Depth of the section is 200 mm, breadth of flange is 100 mm, thickness of flange is 7.3 mm, thickness of web is 5.4 mm, set is set is equal to 169.7 centimeter cube, set P set is equal to 184.34 centimeter cube, R1 is equal to 9.5 mm, IXX equal to 1696.6 centimeter raised to 4, and IYY is equal to 115.4 centimeter raised to 4. Next is classification of section. B is equal to BF by 2. BF means breadth of flange, that is given as 100. 100 by 2 equal to 50 mm. B by TF, that is thickness of flange, is equal to 50 by 7.5, that is equal to 6.67, that is less than 9.4 epsilon. Epsilon is equal to 1 for compression member. And next is D by TW, depth by thickness of web is equal to. So first of all, we have to find the depth. Depth is equal to overall depth, that is 200 minus 2 into 7.3. 7.3 is the thickness of flange, and minus 2 into 9.5. 9.5 is a factor R1, which we have obtained from the details of the section, and divided by TW equal to 5.4, which is equal to 25.39, which is less than 84 epsilon. Again, epsilon is equal to 1. So by considering these two conditions from IS 800, the section is plastic. And D by TW we have obtained as 25.39, that is less than 67 epsilon. The web will not buckle. Check for web buckling is not required. Next is calculation of shear capacity. V is less than VD, that is shear force is less than design shear force. VD is equal to VN by gamma M0. Here VN is equal to VP, that is VP is equal to AV FY by root 3 gamma MO. That is AV is the shear area for hot rolled, that is H into height into total height, telling total depth of the section multiplied by thickness of web, that is 7.3. Therefore, substituting in the above equation, we get 200 into 7.3 into 250 divided by root 3 into 1.1, that is equal to 191.601 kilonewton. As V is equal to 30, here V is less than VD. Next is check for low shear or high shear. As per clause 8.2.1.2 of IS 800, that is in page 53, if V is less than 0.6 VD, that is shear force is less than 0.6 times design shear force, that is considered as low shear. Therefore, MD is equal to, design moment is equal to beta B into set P into FY divided by gamma M0. Beta B is equal to 1. Hence, substituting in the equation, 1 into 184.34 into 10 raised to 3 into 250 divided by 1.1. That is equal to 41.895 kilonewton meter. And there is a factor, that is 1.2 ZDFY by gamma M0. So we have to check whether MD is greater than or less than this value. So substituting in this equation, 1.2 into 169.7 into 10 cube into 250 divided by 1.1, that is equal to 46.281 kilonewton meter. Hence MD is less than the above factor. Next is check for deflection. As per table 6 in IS 800-2007, maximum deflection should be less than permissible deflection. Maximum deflection is equal to 5W L raised to 4 divided by 384 E into IXX, that is equal to 5 into 10 into 4 into 10 cube whole raised to 4 divided by 384 into 2 into 10 raised to 5, that is E. Young's modulus of steel is 2 into 10 raised to 5 into IXX, that is 1696.6 into 10 raised to 4, which is equal to 9.89 mm. Deflection permissible is equal to L by 300. Hence, deflection maximum is less than deflection permissible. Hence, it is safe. Check for web crippling. As per clause 8.7.4 IS 800-2007, FW equal to, FW means bearing strength of web, that is equal to B1 plus N2 multiplied by TW, thickness of the web, into yield stress into W divided by gamma M0. B1 is equal to 75. That is, we can assume any value between 75 and 100. N2 is equal to 2.5 into thickness of flange plus R1. We know that thickness of flange is 7.3 and R1 is equal to 9.5. So substituting in the equation, we get N2 is equal to 42. So substituting in FW, that is bearing strength of web, that is equal to 75 plus 42 into 5.4 into 250 into 10 by 1.1, that is equal to 1435.90 kilonewton. Hence, FW is greater than shear force. Hence, it is safe. Hope you understand the problem. Thank you.